Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. Here is your English teacher, Ma'am Bushra. Hope you all will be in good health, safe and sound. Let's start our today's class. So just open your Oxford Progressive English. Open page number 10. On page number 10, here is a poetry and it is about Across the Indus. In this poetry, the poet is expressing his feelings similar to Imran Khan's in Simar in Mari. Just like Imran Khan has shared his experience when he was in Mari and how he experienced over there, similarly, the poet is expressing his feelings when he was across the Indus. So let's start our poem. How beautiful it seems. How beautiful, how nice it seems. That crowded, festering, insistent city. Crowded means a lot of people. When a lot of people are gathered in a place, so we call it that place is crowded. So the writer, the poet, is saying that place Indus is crowded, means there are a lot of people there. Festering means infectious, okay, something which bring infection. So he thinks that the city is crowded, there are a lot of people there, it is festering, it is infectious. Insistent city, and the city is also insistent. Dirt, you know what is dirt? I hope all of you will know what dirt is, okay. Dirt, barren, heat, the cruel drone of flies. Barren heat means intense heat, okay. Barren, we call barren land to those land which are unable to produce something. So barren heat here means intense heat, the heat which destroys the crops, the heat which does not make the land to grow something. So the heat in Indus is barren heat, means it is intense heat over there. The cruel means harsh, okay. The cruel drone of flies. Drone means a very light, a very low humming sound, okay. The murmuring sound, the humming sound, the buzzing of the flies, we call it drone of flies, okay. So the writer, the poet, is saying that area, it is crowded, there are a lot of people there, the area is festering, it is infectious, it is insistent, okay. There is dirt, there is barren heat in Indus, and there is the cruel drone of flies, there is a harsh buzzing and humming sound of flies. I hope you all would have heard the buzzing of flies, and it is very irritating, especially in the season of summer, okay. So these buzzing flies or these murmuring of flies is there in Indus too. The source paraded to indifferent eyes. Source means pain, okay. Source mean pain. Paraded means moving, marching, okay. I hope you all would have seen the soldiers when they are parading. So they are moving, they are marching, okay. To indifferent eyes. Indifferent means having no interest. So the poet is saying that the pain is moving to indifferent eyes. It means that people feel pain in their eyes. It doesn't mean that your eyes are hurting. This is not that pain, okay. It means that They are not happy there. There is a lot of crowd. There is infectious. It is insistent. The heat is very intense, okay? And there is drone of flies. So all this scenario, all this environment, it brings pain. It brings sadness in the eyes of people, okay? And people are not having any interest in this environment. So they are unhappy with this environment. The ruined houses. Ruined means destroyed, okay? The ruined houses leaning to each other. Leaning means, lean means to bend, okay? Or tilted. So if you have ever seen when an earthquake came, the houses, they lean, they tilt to each other. So the houses in Indus, they are ruined, they are destroyed, okay? And they are leaning, they are tilted to each other. Disgorging naked, unappealing children. Disgorging means pouring, okay? Coming out, pouring. And naked means clothless, having no clothes on the body. So the there, as we have read in the very second line, that that city is crowded. So in that crowd there are also children, and those children are naked, okay? They are not having clothes on their body, and they are disgorging, they are coming out of their houses just like a cloud. There are a lot of children, they are all naked, and they are coming out of their houses. They are disgorging like a cloud. Unappealing. Unappealing means not attractive, not fascinating. So the children are unappealing, they are not fascinating, they are not attractive, and they are just coming out from their homes like a cloud, okay, like an ocean. Playing their games in self-created filth. Filth means dirt, impurity, okay? So the filth, the dirt, which is created by themselves, they are playing in that filth, they are playing in that dirt. And rising, waiting, casting its heavy mantle. Rising, I hope you all know what is the meaning of rise, okay? Waiting, casting. Casting means spreading its heavy mantle. Mantle means cover, okay? The suffocating, obliterating dust. Suffocating means out of oxygen when there is low oxygen, and obliterating means destroying completely, okay? So the dust in that, now there the poet is talking about the dust in Indus, that the dust is so intense that it seems like if it is casting its heavy mantle. The dust is covering the whole city just like a cover, just like a blanket, okay, which is being spread on something. When we spread a blanket or a cover on something, it covers that object completely. So the writer is saying here that the dust in Indus is too much, that it seems like if it is covering everything in it. The whole city is covered in dust. And due to the dust, there is so much suffocation there. One cannot breathe easily. There is problem in breathing. It's suffocating. Swirling. Swirling means moving round and round. Swirling forever in the noisy lanes. Lanes, places, okay? The dust, it is just swirling. It is moving round and round in the lanes, in the places of Indus. So in the first paragraph, the poet is sharing the very ugly look of Indus, okay? The very ugly look of Indus, that it is crowded, it is festering, there is intense barren heat over there, and there is continuous humming and buzzing of flies which make people very annoying, very irritated, and there is pain, there is sadness in the eyes of the people they are very sad, they are not happy, and the houses there are destroyed, they are tilted towards each other. People, the children there, they are not attractive, they are naked, and they are too much in number that they are just disgorging, they are pouring out and out. And the children there, they are peeing in the filth which is created by themselves. And then they, in the end, he discussed the dust there, that the dust is covering the whole city in itself. So we have just read the first para, and in that we have learned that the city, about the Indus, okay, Indus. And I think it's enough for today. What is your task? You have to write the meanings of the difficult words. Use dictionary, consult the dictionary for that. You all will be having dictionary. If you are not having the dictionary, buy one for yourself. Write the meanings of the difficult word, and you will came to know when you have your dictionary in your hands that one word have a lot of meanings. Okay, so write the meaning of the difficult words and read this text once again. Read it by yourself. I think it's enough for today. Take care of yourself. Allah Hafiz.